All right, buddies. It's moving vlog time. It's only been 12 months, Shelly. Are you ready for this? I think she's pretty ready for this. She's pretty excited about this.
I am.
You said, no, we will not be moving.
And
sold.
I walked in the other house and was like, okay, I can do this.
Yeah. So I'll talk more about this over the next few days or weeks or how long it takes us to get moved in. But the reason we're moving, we don't like it here. This house is really nice now. It kind of stinks that we finally finished it and now we're ditching it. But the house is too small for our liking. The potential for us to build our house is going to be multiple years. It's going to take us a couple of years to build the place. And we've been looking every day for months, and since we moved in here, and we found a place that's pretty cool. So you'll see it. We'll go over there today. We got to go to our closing, then we're going to do a walkthrough, then closing, get the keys, take possession, and all the money's been wired. I think I already signed all the paperwork, so I'm not even sure what I got to do with the closing. Probably just notarize a few documents, and then we go check it out. But the movers are coming here today, so they're packing. So we got to work through that, and I'll vlog that here today. And then we'll probably start moving. Like, I'm going to move my speakers and a few. You have to move, like, your money and your guns and your jewelry and all that crap. So we'll move that ourselves. And then we'll start to assess the situation next at the next house. It's only, a mile and a half down the road. So simple deal. And then tomorrow that's when they'll actually physically move everything. So we paid, it's about 2x. So you think it's like $2,200 to move and $2,200 to pack. So you pay the $2,000 to have them pack, so we don't have to do anything. Like, we've literally done nothing and we're moving today and tomorrow. They haven't taken the TV, first TV off the wall. Haven't done a darn thing. Oh, Shelly, they did buy the TV in the garage, so I don't have to take that one down. But that's the easiest one to take down, figures. I don't want to do any wall patching or anything. But the nice thing is, we did sell our house yesterday. So we were at the International Builder Show, and while we were at the show, I was there on Tuesday and Wednesday. Someone came and looked at our house twice. They made us an offer yesterday morning, and we countered and they accepted. So I'll save the prices out of respect to the people buying the house, and I'll tell you later. But I think it's an equal exchange. I think it's less than what I was asking. It's less than what I've spent. But you have to remember that me sharing these videos and making vlogs and talking about products and then just the learning experience of learning things has been super useful for me for the future. And the hope is that I can continue to, educate myself as we lead into building, the Mormon compound, which will be really pretty incredible. I learned lots of stuff at the International Builder Show. I did do some more videos for Inside the Hex. So if you're not a member there, I think you're going to want to become one for, if you want all the details, all the stuff on what we're doing with building a house and building out Destination Obsessed Garage and what I'm planning to do there as we foray more into garage transformations, wash and drive, more produced stuff sprinkled in with my normal long form content, and as well as doing some, my entrance into certain aspects of the house, like lighting. And of course, we're going to share all of the details. Like for example, we found and just made a relationship with a French reclaimed flooring manufacturer. And those are the floors that we're going to do in the Mormon compound, the first Destination OG property that we're going to put together and build. And then my hope is we can sell things like Zip HydroTap. We can sell things and provide solutions for. I found a really amazing semi-DIY closet organization system. Most of them are junk. This one is quite a bit different, so I'll be sharing with you that stuff as I figure that out for the interim house. So here's the plan. Move out of this house, move to another interim house, which suits us better because it's going to take us a couple of years to build the Mormon compound, begin construction of the Mormon compound and selecting and producing a whole massive video series around the construction of that house while building out the Destination Obsessed Garage website. And 2 years from now, we move into that house and we sell the other interim house, which I'm sure I will do some improvements. But Michelle says I'm only allowed to do four things. So we'll talk about those four things. I would guess I'll do 45 things. But I'm going to put my contacts in and let's take a walk around this house and I'll show you what it looks like and then we'll show you what it looks like at the end. All right, here's what we're looking like. Everything's together. Everything is about to get torn apart. So basically what they do today is they come open all the cabinets. Now remember, we purged and cleaned and organized, and so I would guess they're going to be out of here rather quickly outside of the garage, which is pretty chock full of cool stuff. So I'll show you what I'm planning to do there to keep things somewhat organized. But Kate's room, even like our cabinets, like we don't have piles. Kate probably has the most stuff in her cabinet. So everything's pretty well set up. Like, you know, this is probably a tenth full. And then, you know, our closets are good. So they'll box up all our clothes and all of that stuff. And Michelle's dropping the kids off. Should we drop Chase off so he's not here messing with us? And then what I'm going to do is all of my speaker stuff, like all of my down audio stuff, I'm going to take those over there separately just so they don't have to get wrapped up and all that. Actually, I may get the boxes down. I may go get those and load that stuff up. So it's not too bad. You know, we don't have things chock full of junk. But when the TVs come off, so they bought the one in the garage, but not the other two, which is fine. So I'm going to pull the TVs down, or they'll pull the TVs down, wrap those up. And then, yeah, I mean, if you think about it, I'm going to take all of my NAD stuff, because I don't want to get that scratched up or boxed up. And then in our closets. So, looking pretty good. I think they'll have this done in early afternoon and then pick everything up and move it out. You know, so like, you know, we have things pretty well dialed and we'll keep piles of trash in our drawers. You know, so we should be good. So yeah, everything's good, organized. You know, it also helps. I mean, we have it like this most of the time, but it also helps that when you prep for showing the house, it makes it easier. So let's go in the garage and I'll tell you what I'm planning here. So the issue is that I don't have cabinets because the cabinets stay here. And part of the requisite to sell was that we're going to leave everything as is in the house and the garage. So the solar, all that stuff, all the air compressor, those reels, TV, so all that stuff stays, and no speakers. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to label each drawer. I'm going to do that right now with a piece of tape. And then I'm going to have them label the boxes as they take things out. So I'm going to label the drawer. So they'll take all the stuff out, put it in a box, and that'll be labeled whatever I label here. So I'm going to number them all. And that way I know which tool grid goes with which set of tools, and I can keep things organized. So let's say these four drawers go in one box, then that box will be labeled, and I'll take some photos of it, and that way I can find things as I need them. So that's what I'm planning to do, and I'll have them box this up last. I'll get some stuff out of the attic, get a roller and a paintbrush, because I'll need that. And the cool thing is we don't close on this till March 16th.
So after it's all emptied out, I come back here and then just touch everything up for the next people. Unlike what I guarantee you the house we bought is going to look like, which you'll see it in an hour and a half or so to go do the walkthrough. So air compressor, the bike lift, that stuff's staying here. Everything else is going. And what we'll do is we have them dump everything. They put everything in, like all the furniture and stuff, in the right area. And then they put all the boxes in the right area. And then I'll unbox everything. We'll have the whole house unboxed, put away, I would guess by Saturday afternoon. You know, I'll have it done pretty fast, which I really enjoy this process. And it's especially, it's even easier than when we moved here, because we have like literally half the amount of stuff that we had before. Pressure washer stays. So, yeah. Subwoofers and speakers don't. So I'm gonna move the cars out so they have room to work, and we're gonna get moving. All right, people, it's happening. We're rolling. Yeah, I really like this house, man. But yeah, it's time to move on. It's part of the fun, part of the spice of life. So friends from Village Movers are here. And what I'm working on, as you can see, is building a grid of numbering each drawer. I'm going to photo this, and I'll also take a photograph of each insert of the drawer. That way, when I'm putting this back together, or what I'm probably going to do is in the next house, I'm probably going to just take all the tool grid and just lay it out across the back wall on the floor until I get some sonic cabinets. And then sonic, I'm probably going to do foam inlays. And so I'm going to lay that all out, but I'm going to take photos of all of this one drawer at a time so I know where everything is. And that'll be a much smarter system this time. But you guys, I'm going to start in the kitchen, just start dialing it in. I would be okay if you accidentally punted that frickin' china like down a flight of stairs. I've been trying to throw that away for 10 years.
Just get you to sign something real quick.
Yeah. I'll pay you to break that crap.
We'll take payment up front.
All right. Michelle, I've tried to get rid of this stuff so many times. Like, what? We haven't used it in 15 years and we're never going to use it. It's that fancy crap you get when you're like 20 and you think you're going to use it. But you spend like your entire like life savings on it. It's stupid. I think the greatest part about paying this money to have these guys come and do it, they do this all day, every day. I know exactly how to do it. It just stinks that we do all this freaking work to move a mile down the road, but how else are you going to get it there? You know? Yeah. At least we're not moving across the country. It makes it easier. So they'll work through all this stuff. But when Michelle gets back, we'll grab some clothes. We'll just have some stuff for tomorrow. And then I'm telling you, I will have this place unboxed by Saturday afternoon and put away. So I'm an expert at doing this crap. And plus, since we have all that stuff, it's going to be way easier. Okay, system's done. So I took a photo like of that bank and then each individual drawer. That bank, each individual drawer inside each cabinet. And so now this whole thing is all figured out. So I know where everything is and I have a photo reference of it. And so they're going to then correspondingly number the boxes. So again, if they take drawer 19, 20, 21, they'll put and just label 19, 20, 21 on the box. They don't have to worry about saying what it is or figuring out what it is or labeling it correctly. And then that'll solve any of that issue of trying to find a tool. So that's done. I can check that off the list. So now what I've got to do is get some clothes out. So I have those for tomorrow. I'm going to make a little bag of stuff to take with me. All right, we got our 9:45 walkthrough. Not sure what we can do about it. It's a little late now, but we'll talk about this week about what I am going to do about driveway and stuff like that. So, yeah, we're going to have to clean all this up ourselves. Anyway, yeah, so this is the house. 1.67 acres and 4,800 and change square feet. So double and triple. So we negotiated with, we got to fix the backyard ourselves.
Are they great? It looks like they graded a little bit.
Yeah.
You haven't seen the pool.
Huh?
I haven't seen the pool with water.
Yeah. That's the pool. That's our pool.
Pretty.
You like it?
I love it. The kids are gonna love it.
Yeah. Yeah, looks like we gotta clean it up ourselves. That's the way it goes.
Don't worry. We got grandma and grandpa.
We get screwed every time.
It's, I know, ours would be perfect. It's okay.
Yeah.
It's not that bad.
Yep. And that's the way it goes, I guess. Yeah, it's giant, super deep. Ah, crap.
Maybe it's from Dad.
We'll give it to somebody else.
He didn't love it. Have
I don't want that thing. Birdcage looks pretty legit.
So that's where you put your application?
I think so. Yeah, I think that's where I'll put it.
I mean, this could be really awesome.
Yeah, I'm going to make it cool.
The furniture.
Freaking hot tub.
We
get
to go swim today.
Ooh. Yeah, go for it.
Oh, no, they don't.
All right.
They got swim practice.
Let's go, I wanted to look at the water softener. It's so funny. Other people just don't. Like, I would have had it all vacuumed. They just freaking leave stuff laying around. So that's the Culligan system. It's pretty legit. Looks like an iron breaking tank and then a softening. Like, come on, man. That's all right. We're used to it. We are used to it. We're going to have this whole thing pressure washed and painted. That's one of the four things that I'm allowed to do. We'll dial in the landscaping like we did at the last house. Let's see, we at least have a yard. No, that's good. Now the front door has to be fixed. So we're going to paint this thing white with black trim, I think. There we go. And that. And that.
So, oh boy. I mean, I knew that's how it would be, but yeah. I mean, I've got to fix everything. Every door, every wall, every freaking square inch of this thing has got to get fixed. But that's part of the fun, you know, like this.
Like, freaking fill your holes, man. I think that's how they mounted the TV with drywall anchors. What the heck is wrong with people? Like, what? You just leave it like garbage. Like, I'm worried about touching up the walls and patching everything and making sure the grass is correct. But our painters are coming in a few weeks, and so I won't have to do it. But I'm going to have them touch up this whole frickin' thing, every square inch, every baseboard. And everybody blames it. Well, we have kids. Well, so do I. So... And anyway, I've got this freaking giant TV I gotta get rid of. So carpeting's coming next Thursday. Mike and I are gonna rip that whole freaking fireplace out. Get it dialed in.
Okay. So I'm calling today as soon as we close. That's my two jobs. Okay.
This room is insane. Like, so big. Monstrous. So, yeah, so we got carpet coming for the whole house, about 10 grand worth of carpet. That was the other second. That was the second thing I was allowed to do. Third thing is closet organization. So, yeah, not a big deal. We fix all the walls. We clean up everything. And we got to fix a lot of the cabinet stuff.
You were saying you never seen anyone like that.
So we bought this and that because furniture is so hard to get.
That's our
check. So let's go look at the garage.
That's where they left. We have these keys.
See, this is what Brian was talking about. All the. He could probably do a backsplash. I'll probably rip that out and redo it. No, that's not one of the four things. Yeah, so we got some prepping to do. But this is fun. This is what's going to be great about that we get to go and redo. Rebuild. This garage is going to be great. What's up with that? Oh, crap. You can see that. Okay. So, I'm going to paint this. I'm not going to drywall this garage. We're going to paint the whole thing hardwood gray. And then figure out what I'm gonna do with just dial everything in, get rid of these garbage openers, and I'm gonna do some magic stairs on cue. Let's see, some wire. We'll see how it goes.
What do you think, Shelly? Are we gonna make this place great?
Yeah, we might have to add to our list of only four things.
I knew it. That's why I agreed to this list of four things. What the heck is going on?
Yeah,
I can't see.
The boys did that last night.
Oh, you like the panoramic?
The sunroof. Well, it's just when their stuff is in there, I didn't see all the walls banged up, the baseboards of this, the out. You know, it's just a lot of little things.
Well, we'll fix it.
But it's gonna, it it's can just, be amazing.
It just stinks that we feel obligated to fix all that stuff, but every other person in the world doesn't give a crap.
But you know? I believe it.
They're like, let me get out of here. Yeah, you're right. It
if
does come
you
back.
Treat things and do the right thing, then it's going
to
come back.
Well, yeah, it comes back around to me having to do it again and again.
You know what, though?
But I don't want them doing it because then they're going to mess it up, so I need to stop complaining.
Yeah, it's going to be great. But we're gonna have a lot of content probably of things you're gonna be doing to this house.
I told you. I just agree, yeah. We'll only do four things.
I know. You're not trying to lie. You're just knowing that I'll change my mind.
I'll talk you into it. Mm-hmm. Alright, so we're going home, check on the movers. I've got to do nothing. We're good. We gotta go to closing. Towels. So I just called. We're heading over to. We're gonna get some Chipotle because we're a little early. So we decided not to go back home. We're just going to closing here at Leesburg. It's like 20 minutes from my house, something like that. So we're gonna grab some Chipotle for early lunch. We'll go over, sign our docs. Then we can go back and start moving stuff. Start moving my speakers and all that stuff over. Got a broken muffler on the Badcock truck. So. It's a darn furniture truck next to us. So I just called Seco. Not looking good. I'm trying to transfer our energy or power bill, and not transfer, but set it up in our name. And they're like, well, we don't have that address on file, so I got to go get the number off the meter. Then I called Comcast. I can just apparently just do that online, so I'll probably make that transfer over tomorrow. So that way we can have internet and watch our computers and iPads, keep our kids off our back for the weekend. So hopefully I ought to be able to hook the modem up, just screw it in and turn it on. That's what I'm hoping. So the place is actually right up here. We're going to run down the street, grab some Chipotle, and then go do our closing.
Made it to closing. I got to get that Raptor dialed in. So many things to do. So Southern Title, going to closing. For those of you young guys haven't done this before. Title does the title work. Title company does title work, and you do all your closing, fill out your paperwork, and you own the house.
Yeah, man.
All right, done deal. We signed the deal. So paperwork signed. They're signing the other side of it. So the transaction will be done in about 10 minutes. So we're gonna go and do whatever we do now. I'm gonna take you along the rest of the day. Mike's gonna meet us at the house. And
he is.
Yeah, because we're just gonna go over the things I need to do. He'll bail me out of the chaos and. That's a scoop. So Michelle is already reneging on her four things. She's like, you know, does Dynonio make any kind of speakers where you could kind of point it out at the pool? Because that doesn't count in the four things. This is how it goes, show. It's a slippery slope. Next thing you know, I'm doing Isonine and I'm doing the Tesla Solar. And then we're building an addition on the garage. And
Even today alone, I've thought of, oh, we should put a sand volleyball court. Oh, we should put a pool house with a bathroom and a shower, an outdoor shower. And now speakers. So it's like, I see why you do this.
Yeah. Would you rather pay off the house or make it great?
Make it great.
That's how it goes.
But that's what responsible answer.
Gonna carry you through over the threshold.
Yeah.
Get out of here. Oh, that's the outside light. I'm gonna fill up the garage with garbage. Ooh, they left us my favorite water. Look.
I was gonna say, not even your type of water. That was nice of them. Look at all the paint colors.
I gotta throw this crap away.
I know. Stuff. We'll do more
Alright, I'm gonna think about this logically.
I'm gonna clean. I'm gonna vacuum out this garage first. Part of the advantage of a disaster. Part of the advantage of disasters that other people have is that it's much more rewarding when you clean it up. But like, it's unbelievable. It's a $1.2 million house, and I got to freaking mop it and clean it. Oh Lord, people, don't do this to others. Be better. It's got to come back around in the world. So anyway, I'm gonna vacuum out the garage first. I'm going to stop. I'm going to grab the Ego blower. I'm going to grab some speakers. I'll bring my GT4 back here and maybe the Tesla. And then I'll start in here. And then from here, we'll go into the kitchen. And, well, I'll show you what we're doing. But anyway, we just unloaded Michelle's truck with all the junk that she had in there for some reason. Driving around everywhere. And then, if Michelle was selling the house, this is what it would look like. All right, Shelly?
Be nice.
So, anyway, 18-foot garage door insulated, which is nice. This insulated door. I think it's insulated. Yeah, it's insulated. And so, I've got the garage door openers already, so we'll do that. I need to find if we have some tile. I'll send Mike up there when he gets here. He'll climb up there and see if we got it. Anyway, you got everything? I'm going to throw all this paint away. I'm going to try to find which is just the interior paint. Because we're painting the exterior all fresh and new, so we're just gonna ditch all this crap. Sure you don't want to change your mind, Shelly? Look at this place. It is dialed. I wish I could buy a house from me. No more, actually, after this interim house, no more selling houses. We're gonna own them all. Just keep them. Nobody gets hooked up anymore. That's the plan. So, thinking through. Doing all our stuff here. It's good. Good, you got my system, the number system?
Yes, sir.
Did that help you guys? Or was that
oh!
Okay, that's fine.
All they have to do is write on there. They have to write,
yeah. Helping us help him.
Yeah,
we're helping each other.
Yeah, this is great. Crank it through. All right, well, we own the house. So,
all right.
It's a good thing. So we're moving. This room's boxed. Boxed. All boxed up, ready to go. All right, I'm gonna take the GT4. There's something about taking your car to a new house. It's like introducing your pet to a new house. Let's see how it fits. All right, I'm gonna unload the truck with some speakers. I like to bring the speakers. And we got a lot of speakers, right, Shelly?
Oh my gosh, the whole car is full of speakers.
Speakers, Ryan's monitor, they'll bring the TVs. They're better at bringing the TVs than I am. But everything got here in one piece. All right, well, we're trying to figure out how to get in the attic, see if they got any tile. Project number one is, always, rip out the fireplace.
Yeah.
We got a million other things to do, but I decided to rip out the fireplace. So we hooked that Look at that strap on there, because this is 12 feet up. Look at that. Look at that. You like this, the garage door openers? They're not even the same. One's Chinese junk, and the other one is Chinese medium.
Good.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. This is something special, Mike.
It is. Oh, don't get it. We'll fix it.
Yeah. But, I'm laughing, but I knew what we were getting.
Yeah.
You and I came through this. No, I didn't know that I was going to be cleaning up the last person's garbage on my $1 million house. But
there's so much stuff, and you have 30 minutes to look at it. You don't see all this, necessarily.
Well, I saw it. I just knew.
Well, I mean, all the dirt. I didn't see all this dirt.
Yeah, I did. That's what I'm wearing my shoes in here. So, yeah, this is... it's good. But here's the beauty. That the before and after, yeah.
It's going to be huge.
But it's crazy that I'm the freaking guy buying the $1 million house from the people who bought it for $700,000. They made 400 bones off of me.
Yeah, and you'll
and
do it right.
I've got to clean it.
And you'll do it right, and you won't make 400 bones off the next person.
No, I'm going to lose 400. And you know what's going to happen? My house that's for sale, they're going to nitpick. Mm-hmm. Like.
Oh, yeah.
You know
they expect perfection based on everything else they see.
Right, so, right, exactly.
There's a little scratch right here. Come on. Let me show you the house I just bought.
Oh my gosh. Yeah, let's get out of here. All right, so Mike and I got this licked. We got movers are going to come tomorrow. We're going to knock out getting all the just walls patched up and doing the opposite of what I'm dealt. Get this place done. We'll roll out Ryan's dirt wall and get like the things like the TVs and that off the wall and make sure that we patch any holes or anything like that for the next people. Even though they're going to put a TV in the same spot, probably. Just do the right frickin' thing.
Leave a blank slate for them.
It stinks. I'm gonna leave these C80s. These are $1,200 a piece.
So we should have the old ones.
No. We should get some PSBs and put them up in there. Yeah.
I almost would.
Yeah.
That time.
Maybe I might do that. We'll see what it looks like.
$4,800. They will never know.
I know.
They won't even appreciate that.
They won't have a clue.
It's other speakers, right?
Yeah, we'll upgrade.
Yeah,
I don't have the time to mess with those. I'm going to leave them in there. That'll be fine. I remember, I'm buying at a deep discount, so.
Yeah, that's true. Retail, we were talking retail.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. All right, well, Samina, good night. I'm gonna go and do some late night cleaning. Get prepared for all this stuff. But it's not, I mean, that's the whole kitchen in like a dozen boxes. Whole garage.
You guys kill it. It's worth it. You told me what they charge. It's like not even worth doing yourself.
It's $2,500 or $2,200 or something.
That's insane. That's really good.
Yeah.
I wouldn't miss it.
All right, Mike. You got our irony set up here?
Yeah, we do.
Yeah.
So
Tesla irony.
Here we are.
It's going to make all our Californian buddies angry. So you can't, the movers can't.
They can't touch this.
Yeah, why? So I got to take the guns myself.
Yeah.
So we'll take those over there. I don't know how to use any of them, but I got them.
You got an AR, a Beretta 12 gauge, you got your Sig Sauer 9.
Yeah. Lots of prep. That's about the fifth of the ammo I got. So
yeah.
I need to buy some more for the Armageddon zombie apocalypse.
Yeah.
All right, we're going back over to the other house.
All right. Didn't find the battery for this thing. We're going to head back over to the other house. I'm going to start cleaning. So it was good. Mike came, so we got everything figured out. I got the garage at least cleaned out with the junk. I'll make a run over to HQ with a bunch of trash, and I'll get my battery and a charger for this thing.
Uh-oh, what are you guys doing? You guys are chumps. What's up, bro? What do you think? Did you guys even go inside?
Yeah.
You jump in the pool?
No. You got swim practice.
Oh, nice job, Shelly. This looks great.
This is kind
of
cool.
Like, how wouldn't you want to live with your fridge looking like that?
It's a different drawer.
It's so much better.
I kind of like that.
When it's clean.
Yeah, look how it's nice now. Look how clean out it is.
What is wrong with this? So, yeah. All right. Well, it makes it, okay. Makes you appreciate
we're
it
we're only done half of it. Look at the bottom.
How dented is it?
I don't think it's dented.
Not too many dings.
I haven't seen any. They put a piece of tape on it, so we gotta get some adhesive. Nice. Like, we need Goo Gone.
Oh.
But it's not scraped, it's just like a piece of tape.
Yep. Cool. Well, the garage is coming together. It's dirtier than I could have possibly imagined. So, yeah. Anyway, I did this part. It took me 30 minutes. And I still, I'm going to have to scrape the floor. Yeah, it's worse than I could have imagined. But anyway, we're working on it. One step at a time.
All right, making it happen. Look how much cleaner it looks. It's so much better.
Oh my gosh, it looks so much better. Obsessed garage, we didn't start with the garage. Oh yeah, we're gonna. I was thinking we would leave these lights alone, but no. We're gonna update these for sure. We'll have to see what's up there. Though. I hope they're regular cans and not J-Box stuff. But look at how much better the fridge looks. I mean, still need to polish it up a bit more, but much better. We'll clean up these. get the sticker off. Yeah. What's that? Oh my gosh. This is like from when I installed it. Well, we're gonna keep there's still some painter's tape on there. Oh man, we're gonna dial this place in. This is gonna be a transformation for sure. Yeah, wouldn't it
hurt people to use a sponge or something? Or they moved out?
No, they Swiffered this, I guarantee. Swiffer 10 minutes.
Oh, look at this, and they stopped short. That's it. Didn't even go to the end.
Really?
Yeah, it's right here. Yeah.
Oh boy.
We got some what the hell is that for? Well, you got something else under here.
Pre-wire. Post-wire.
Oh no, there's another one. And they just cut the wires off. There was another one.
Yeah. You know how much I love LED strip lighting. Oh,
this is amazing.
Yeah.
No, really. You know what you need to do is...
I was trying to pull that tape off that's been sitting under the blue tape, painter's tape.
You saw that?
Yeah. The painter's tape's been left.
What do you think that upgrade cost them? $15, probably.
Ooh, I think they might have gotten ripped off of that number.
Yeah, that's nice.
Don't worry about Look at that. This. Look at how big... This garage is big, man. It's nice.
You got 8 feet or 7 feet in front of this car.
Yeah.
Let's see.
I can't be selling any more cars. Yeah, this is good.
Get 6 foot 9 in front of the car right now.
Let me get the Tesla. And then this door, this is a 9 foot wide door, I think.
Let's see.
Not eight.
It's probably nine.
Because the 8 foot door is like impossible to get in and out of.
It's, I think it is nine.
The 8x9.
Yep, actually it's, right on nine.
Sweet, I'm gonna pull a Tesla and see
and
how it feels. All right, we did what every good garage guy does. Clean the garage first. And bring the vacuum in here. Gonna vacuum up a little bit. And we called Sherwin-Williams, and in Florida, like, there's no paint disposal. You throw it away. So we're gonna take all that. I've gotta take all the garbage from the front of the house because they loaded up the recycling bin with garbage and just left it there for us. And but look how much room there is. It's freaking awesome. This garage is gonna be really cool. It's really tight to come into this bay, this garage, or this, whatever you call it. The 8 foot, 9 foot door. So it's an 18 foot and a 9 foot, but they're 8 feet tall, which is great. When we do the jack shaft operators and do some lights in here, it's gonna be freaking sweet. So, yeah, this is cool. I'm gonna go start working in the kitchen. So my parents came over to help me clean up. Shell's got the kids at swimming camp or something, or swimming something or other.
Yeah, I thought
they got. Yeah. Oh. They're goofy. We're gonna pull out the sink
out. He doesn't sure. like this.
Like the utility sink?
Yeah.
Well, I mean, I don't mind a sink, but that is goofy.
Yeah.
That's some cheap crap right out the Home Depot shelf.
Yeah, definitely.
You gotta figure out how to level the doors because they're all closing on us.
Then, this is Ryan's room?
Yes.
Yeah. Ryan's room? He's got a closet, big closet. This is box inside. So. Goes all the way around. You can put dressers in here, but you don't need
them. Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Plenty big. Figure what he's got now.
The ceilings are so
sure.
Yeah. And then he doesn't want this back because he don't want a bathtub.
Well, he'll probably end up using it, I'm sure.
There's a bathtub in this. Look at this. It's cool. I like that.
Yeah. I mean,
that's a shower. It looked like I didn't even see it. Yeah, we pray some with some good ones and we're in good shape.
The food's so nice. I mean, they're good.
Yeah, they seem alright.
Yeah. The floor's nice.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Carpets will be here on Thursday.
We left us some stuff.
Yeah, well, with this stuff sure.
They only left us stuff with junk that we
didn't.
Yeah,
we just throw away.
Yeah.
No ceiling fans, that's alright.
Oh, I got three, four of them I just got.
Okay.
That I ordered months ago for the other house. Like, didn't put them in, I kept them.
This is Kate's house, so
that's
the public place. Yep. Oh, well, I kind of think it's kind of different. Yeah, look how big it is. She has a tiny little room now, you know?
Right. Yeah.
Which one had all the things on the wall?
This one.
Oh, there it is right there.
The only thing is, she's getting ripped off on a closet again.
Well, it's the still girl. Giant.
Huh? But it's the girl. Well, this toy, she's going to be a little loving that.
Yeah.
But she can use the toy closet, won't she?
All right, so we're working through spraying invisible glass on there. We're working through cleaning out the each interior, exterior of the cabinet. So that one's done, yeah. And we're getting this place dialed in. One crack and crevice at a time. Yeah, I can climb up there. I'll bring my full ladder and I'll just vacuum it.
Yeah,
and then before
we'll
I wipe it.
Then we'll wipe it. Yeah.
Yeah, so you can see what we're, I just vacuumed this out. Now I'm gonna wipe it out. And I'm wiping the faces of the cabinets down. So I did these and getting all the door handles all nice and cleaned up. Vacuuming like all these little crevices, all this stuff up in here. Getting the thing dialed. We got a whole team going, a crack team going. Cleaning out the top of the microwave. Kids are playing football in the giant living room. I'm working on the stainless. Cleaning it up. I'm never gonna be able to unsee that now, Shelly. I'm gonna have to get a new one.
What, that?
You guys, you guys notice something about this? So look at the display, it's like, dirt. That's really weird how that's even possible. That's really weird. I'm gonna have to get a new one.
Oh, no, you're not.
All right, we're making progress.
What is this?
What? It's gonna be all grease from cooking.
Yeah, but what did you leave it there for?
Leave what?
I thought you did that.
Did what?
That.
What are you talking about? Oh, no, I didn't do that. I just hit the top of it. Yeah, so we're cleaning off the backsplash, doing the counters. I just cleaned off all the stainless in there, cleaned that all out. Michelle did all these over here, and did all this. All that's done. Working on the stainless steel over here. Man, what a difference. Kitchen looks good. So we're going to save the island for tomorrow.
Oh, that's
well, that doesn't work. Just leave it closed. It stinks.
It don't work?
No. I got to get a new one. That was in the negotiation.
Yeah. Yeah.
Appliances look really nice now. I don't know about all that, but... So we got to fix... Several doors, the Lazy Susan doors broken off, so Michael saved the day. I don't think we can do much about the outlets. We might be able to work on them a little bit to straighten them out. I gotta get a new hood.
Just look at it this way.
Yeah.
Turn your head and it won't show.
And then I'll bring one of my ladder gets here. I'll bring the 8-foot ladder I'll vacuum the upper, up top there.
Yes, it will.
I think, and we're going to have to change the color temp in this whole house. It's all, I guess maybe it's only 4K. They just have the wrong color temp bulbs in the fixtures. They have 5K bulbs, and then it looks like they're probably 4K. I think the style of this house, I think 4K bulbs are fine. But I made some good progress here on day one. Closed on the house. Yeah, but that's in fairness, my lights are probably like that too.
They shouldn't be. Same on you.
Yeah.
My lights are not like that.
Yeah.
I can tell you how to really keep it on.
So, I think our bar shows are going to look pretty good here. Mm-hmm. The black ones?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
So, they'll have us moved, I think, pretty quickly. I think by 3 o'clock, we'll probably be in here. And so, I'm going to be wanting to put all the utensils and all that stuff in the cabinets, and so that's the good news is that we have them all cleaned out. How many cabinets are over there in the island?
Well, we got a nice dishwasher,
so
just one and these two. This is
right. Should we just finish it?
Yeah.
Alright, let's do it. That way that tomorrow I can do my thing. Alright, let me clean this out. Alright. Clean.
Okay.
Clean, clean, clean. We did the island, we did the inside, we did the outside, we did the cabinets. We gotta tear the rest of that light thing off of there. We're looking good, looking really good. Step one, done. Garage is cleaned a bit. Kitchen's cleaned a bit. Next up, we'll do the bathrooms. And we'll do the floors, and then we'll start tearing stuff apart. But tomorrow's move-in day.
All right, people, I'm home. What time is it? 8:35. Not bad, not a late night. Kitchen's completely clean. We did the counters, we did the island, we did everything. We did the stove, the double oven, the whole deal. Got any words of wisdom for anybody?
No, everybody? I got nothing.
You beat up?
Yes.
You didn't really work all that hard, though.
No, I just.
Just seems like just feels like a long day. Yeah.
Yeah.
So anyway, we'll see you tomorrow, day two of the moving vlog. It's gonna be a fun time. I'm gonna sit down and I'm all sweaty. My eyes are so itchy from all that dust. But I'm going to edit the video, take a shower, edit the video, relax. Can't watch TV. And see you tomorrow.